This is our second day of training in our Women's Convention 2015. God has allowed us to come together one more time, and I want to let you know I don't take it lightly. I thank him for every day that he leaves me here with life, health, and strength. I have to tell him thank you, because many didn't make it from last year to this year, but you are here. Testimony, God has been good to you. And so we are very, very grateful. Mother's in the building, so she's not at home resting in the bed. She has many, many things to do, and I assured her that we would carry on because we are her daughters and we have been trained well. If anything that bring a parent joy is if they have to leave home, and when they come back, the children have shown that they have been trained, shown that they listen. That brings you great joy. And so we are big girls. Amen. And so we bless the Lord. I want to say to you that the war room is open and you can still sign up. The war room, if you went to the movie, amen, then you understand the war room. War, battle is going on continuously in that room. So if you want to sign up for an hour or more than an hour, feel free to do that. If you've signed up, all you have to do is step out and spend your time in there, then you can come back in service. But the prayer is being made continuously. We know things happen. God is taking us back to time of prayer. This church was birthed through prayer. And so we have left it. We've gotten so busy, and we've forgotten to teach our daughters how to wail, daughters how to mourn. And so it's becoming a lost art, and we are losing out too. And so he's calling us back from a whole lot of other busy stuff we are doing back to a life of prayer. Somebody said, little prayer, little power. More prayer, more power. And I said, great prayer, great power. Praise the Lord. We thank God on this morning. We were blessed by District Missionary Quintina Flowers, and she let us know it's time to step out of mediocrity for a total commitment. Step out of your comfort zone, where you just feel so safe and secure at. And many of us won't do it voluntarily, so God allows things to happen to make us come out. Come on out of the cocoon. You've been in there long enough. It's time you realize you're not a caterpillar, but you are a butterfly. And he has given you wings. It's time for you to flap those wings. If you test them, you're going to find out you can fly. Amen. And so he had to push us out. He pushed me out. Up here, this is not me. Not me. I know you probably said, I can't tell. Not me. That is not my thing. I'd rather be there. Amen. But he pushed me out. He pushed me out. So I had no choice. I told him yes. And when I told him yes, Mother Beulah Jones, I didn't realize what I was in that yes. Say, my God. I had a yes, but I don't want to do this, and I don't want to do that, and I don't want to do that. But you can't have any buts in that yes. It has to be completely yes. And so we thank God. Look at your sister, encourage her. Say, step on out. Come on out. Come on out. He wants total commitment. He doesn't want half-hearted stuff. He wants total commitment. So we thank God for Missionary Flowers. Now I'm going to give you the report for yesterday. She's working on the report for today. We had a slow start on yesterday, but we were here. Our laywomen was taught. Missionary Benita Smith had 10. Missionary Nicole Ward had 11. And Missionary...